Hey YouTube do-it-yourself enthusiasts, boombox enthusiasts. This is Modine here again. This is going to be a series of short videos of my do-it-yourself custom Bluetooth boomboxes versus something you get right off the shelf. So I purchased this Sony SRS-X5 just recently on sale. It's a pretty good unit overall, very nice finished product. It sounds very nice. For about $150, I think it goes for about $150. I recently purchased it on sale for $75 with tax at Fry's with a promo code, Fry's Electronics. So I'm basically going to describe a little bit about each one and then do a sound test and maybe give a few comments at the end. So this little guy is going to get a little beat up. He's going to go head to head with a few boomboxes that I've made. The first one will be this 25 watt per channel with the LCD, Philips LCD TV speakers with Bluetooth in it and a Pelican 1120 box. This guy here is rated at 20 watts, has Bluetooth. Just like this guy here, also has a physical 3.5 millimeter stereo line in. It also does have phone conferencing or calling Bluetooth with your phone that you can actually take calls with. Of course, this one doesn't have it. This does have BB sound processing with tone controls. This does not have tone controls, but it does have a little sound button that sort of almost sounds like it makes the sound stage a bit wider. This does have two tweeters and a subwoofer in the middle. Can't really see it. And then in the back, there's a pair of square rounded off passive radiators. This is rated for 20 watts. Sounds pretty good overall for $70, $75, certainly worth it. Something I can compare to. I don't know if I'd pay $150 for it or even more for the newer SRS-X55, which has supposedly 30 watts. It does have a lithium ion battery, of course, in it. It does sound louder when it's plugged in. But you'll find out too that when you crank this all the way up, it doesn't distort it. There is a algorithm inside to ensure that the speakers are not overdriven. So when you do play it at loud levels, the highs and the lows tend to go away compared to the mid-range. Basically, my designs are very simple. I don't have any kind of limit overdriving the speakers or anything like that. But anyway, I'm going to do a heads up. Head to head, just play the tune and go back and forth on another phone. And in the next few videos, this is going to go against this guy here, the little Bose SoundLink mini replica that I built. This larger recent 2.1 system with a pretty powerful subwoofer. And then this guy too. Unfortunately, I don't have any of the clear Pelican 1050 Bluetooth boomboxes. I've built a few of those and essentially sold or gave those away to friends and family. That would be a perfect matchup, in my opinion, with this guy here. So here we go. First up is my box. This is all done at 50% volume, 2 feet away.
And let me go.
So a couple final thoughts. Sony SRS-X5 sounds actually pretty good overall. Doesn't have the same clarity on top of the mid range, actually in the treble section. Treble sounds a little bit better with the tweeters on my box over here. Mid-range is a little bit better on this guy here, but the low end is, I think, slightly better than this guy over here. The mid-range on the Sony is a little muddy, but overall it sounds pretty good. I brought both of them with me on several out-of-town trips, and they both sound pretty good overall. But for $75, you know, that's a pretty good deal. This one obviously costs more just in parts. But thanks for watching. I'm going to produce a couple more videos. Let me know what you think. I'm going to do this Sony heads up with some of these other custom do-it-yourself Bluetooth boomboxes that I've made. Thanks again for watching.